kings, the Lord of lords. Do it for Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise. Adonai, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you, Jesus. The most divine. Anasialia. Anasialia. Jehovah, be thank you. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise. That you open your mouth and begin to appreciate him. It's a God that taketh not, it's a God that remembers the same. He's faithful, he's able. He deserves our praise, he deserves our glory, our adoration. Father, we thank you. God, we admire thee. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Ashida. In Jesus' name, we have worship.
Amen.
I just sit in God's presence. Hallelujah. Tell somebody Happy New Year. Talk to another person. Say 2022 is your year. You don't know the meaning of what that is. Turn to another person, say 2022 is your year. Jehovah is said to do something upon our lives this year. Something will change. Something will break. Something will metamorphose this year. This year is the year of somebody here. If you are that person, shout the loudest, amen. If you don't say amen, it will come back. If you are that person, shout the loudest, amen. Shout the loudest, amen. Hallelujah. Celebrate grace in the house tonight. Please help me celebrate Minister Nelson O'Malley. God bless you, sir. Celebrate you. Celebrate Apostle Johnson. God bless you, sir. Can also see Minister Daniel. Please celebrate this vessel of God. God bless you. Above all, celebrate yourself. Hallelujah. We thank God for the gift of life. And provided there's life, there's a fact that something, there will be a turnaround. Hallelujah. Today, we're going to know what God has for us as a ministry in the year 2022. Hallelujah. Last year, like this, we gathered and God, the first service the Lord told us is our year of supernatural speed. And by the mercies of God, we did not recover from that word. Why? Because prophecy is a vehicle that pushes you to your destination. When prophecy goes ahead of you, it guarantees delivery of your destiny. When prophecy goes ahead of a man, that is what makes that man to enter what God has for him in that particular jurisdiction. And this year, in the place of prayer, the Lord said 2022 is our year of breaking limitations. Breaking limitations. Celebrate Jesus. In 2022, you are breaking limitations. The Lord said, this year, as a ministry, as a commission, as a people, he said, nothing can stand as a siege. Nothing can stand as an embargo. What it means is that nobody can stop you this year. Nothing can stop you this year. No power from the mother's house. No power from your mother's side. No power from anywhere at all can stop you this year. You believe that, shout the loudest, amen. We believe that hella fire. Hallelujah. Hear me? Some things you could not achieve last year, you are going to achieve them this year. some things that looks like struggles. You are having a mind that you are trying, the more you are trying, the thing is going far from you. This year, you will achieve it with ease. In the name of Jesus. Let's teach briefly. Out of the apostles, thank you, Jesus. 16 from verse 22. Thank you, Jesus. To 26. Breaking limitations. Out of the Apostles 16, from verse 22 to 26. We also appreciate those that have been following and listening to our messages online. Right from last year, that was how God directed us. And then receiving messages of impact by the messages. And I believe that this year, God will make massive impact upon your life. In the name of Jesus. And the multitude rose up together against them. Acts 16:22. And the multitude rose up together against them. And the magistrates ripped off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. 24. Who, having received such a charge, chased them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. 26. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loose. The Lord bless the reading of his word. In this year 2022, there will be a shaking. There will be a particular earthquake that will deliver to you what God wants you to have this year. In the name of Jesus. What is limitation? Hear me. If somebody has experienced limitation before, when the person hears the word breaking limitation, that person will be so excited and so exuberant. Because limitation is a siege. Limitation is an embargo. Limitation is a reproach. Do you know what it means to be living and yet you are in prison? That means you are not in prison physically. You are not in prison physically, but yet your destiny is imprisoned. What is limitation? Number one. Limitation is a siege or an embargo that stands against us getting to our destination. Is a siege or an embargo that stands against us getting to our destination. What is limitation? Number two. Limitation is an aura that brings about stagnation, an aura, an atmosphere, a jurisdiction that brings about stagnation. When a man is limited, that man is stagnated. You cannot see a man that is limited and making progress in life. But this year, Jehovah said, that stagnation is over. But this year, Jehovah said, that limitation is over. Because it's breaking that siege. It's breaking that limitation. You believe that, shout the loudest, amen. You believe that, shout the loudest, amen. What are the limitations God will be breaking in our midst this year 2022? What are the types of limitations that God will be breaking in this year 2022. Number one is called the limitation against our walk with God, or what you call spiritual limitation. Our sister testified, struggling with God. But it will not repeat itself this year in the name of Jesus. That is limitation against your assignment with Jehovah. Limitation against your walk with God. That is, God has given a man a particular walk, but the devil is fighting that walk. God has said, this year I want you to make impact for me. I want you to be vital spiritually. I want you to be a serious intercessor. I want you to be a man that will stand in the gap massively. But yet the devil is fighting that walk. It is called spiritual limitation. Hallelujah. That shall not be our portion this year in the name of Jesus. What are the limitations God will be breaking this year? Number two, it's called limitation against our destinies. That means no destiny is permitted to be confined. No destiny is permitted to be reproached. And above all, no destiny is permitted to be stagnated. That means what God wants you to achieve this year, no witch is witch enough to stop you. No wizard is wizard enough to stop you. Breaking the limitation of our destinies. Hallelujah. What are the types of limitation God will be breaking this year? Number three is called the limitation against careers. That means somebody has chosen this path. You are in business. Something has been limiting you before. Or you are in school. Something has been limiting you before. Or you have chosen a particular kind of career, but something has been limiting you. You have a particular handwork and you do something, but yet something has been limiting you before. What it means is that this year, that limitation is over forever in the name of Jesus. Then what is the fourth type of limitation that God will be breaking this year? It's called the limitation against our finances. Limitation against our finances. That means you are not permitted to handle money and you don't know what that you did with that money before it disappeared. That means you are not permitted to walk in empty-handedness. That means somebody can work for the whole month and the only thing he has in him or her is 50 naira for a whole month. It's an error, sir. It is called financial limitation. Hear me? There's nothing as sweet as spirituality with prosperity. That means you are serving God, but yet you have money. You are serving God. I'm not saying that the money will take you away from God. There are some people that no matter the amount of money they handle, they cannot forget God. There are people that when they handle money, they can run away, they will forget God. But there are some people that when they handle money, that is when they serve God better. Because imagine somebody, you are supposed to come for service and the person does not have transport. How would that person serve God better? But when the person has money for service, it can invite other people. Even when those people don't have transport, it will pay for their transport. Come and be blessed. I will pay for your transport. Hallelujah. That is what finance can do. This year you will not be stranded. Yet. You will not be stranded. You will not be stranded. In the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter what the economy is saying. But Jehovah has given us his word that is breaking the limitation of finances. this year what you could not achieve last year, financially, this year you will achieve them. In the name of Jesus. Briefly, what are the keys to breaking limitations? Because to every uplifting, there's principles. So what are the keys to breaking limit? You want to see limitations broken in your life this year. What are the keys? Number one, the key of goal setting. The key of goal setting. Beloved, don't live your life by chance in this 2022. Have a goal. Goal means having a target. Writing that target down. Lord, this year, this is what I want to achieve. This year, I want to buy a land. You work with it. This year, I want to start putting foundation in that land, that start developing the land I have. You write it down. This year, I want to do this. I want to do that. You know what I mean? A life that is lived by chance is a life that cannot achieve anything. You will see 2022 will end, you will not achieve anything. Why? Because you do not write anything to achieve. How will you achieve something you do not write? When a man does not live by target, when a man does not live by goal, that man can never get the gold. It is gold that gives you gold. At the beginning of 2021, I wrote down the things I want to achieve. I said, Lord, I'm writing these things down. I want to buy this thing this year. I want to settle this thing this year. And then at the end of 2021, I noticed I achieved even more than the things I wrote. Why? Because a man without a goal or a target is a man that can never achieve anything in life. If you want to achieve something in 2022, go on tonight and write it down. The year, today is what? Just the sixth day of 2022. It's not too late at all. It's never too late yet. Right, God, this is what I want to achieve. These are my goals. These are the targets I want to achieve in this 2022. Write them down. And at the end of 2022, you will see what God will do in your life. Beloved, you lived 2021, you lived it by chance. Anything that comes, let me just, anywhere where benefits, don't do like that in 2022. If not, you will not achieve anything, sir. You will not achieve anything, ma'am. Don't live your life by anywhere where benefits. Anywhere where benefits. And you want to enter greatness? Hallelujah. Have a goal. Have a target. Lord, this is my target for 2022. Lord, these are my targets for 2022. I want to achieve these things in 2022. Both spiritually, both in career, both in ministry, both in every aspect of your life. Lord, these are what I want to achieve. And there will be no devil that is devil enough to stop you. Hear me? When God speaks a word, prophecy does, you force prophecies to happen. You make prophecies to happen. Prophecies does not just happen on their own. You engage them. And one of the ways to engage prophecy is by setting a goal. One of the ways to engage the prophecy of this year is by us having a goal. And Jehovah will help us very good in the name of Jesus. What are the keys to breaking limitation? Number two is called the atmosphere of praise and worship. The Bible says Paul and Silas, they were there, they were praising and they were worshiping God. And all of a sudden there was an earthquake. If there's a year in which you have been murmuring, let it not be this year. Don't give room to murmuring. Oh God, why this one? Why this one? Why this one? Complaining. Because the more you complain, the less you obtain. You know? Some people are in cage because of their murmuring. The children of Israel were supposed to spend a particular days in the wilderness. And because of their mama, we talk, this one, why will Moses do this? It was extended. That wilderness is an experience. That wilderness is an experience in which it looks as if things are dry. Some people, the reason why their wilderness experience is extended is because they keep on murmuring about God. When they are supposed to be worshiping, when they are supposed to be praising, they are murmuring and talking against God. And God say, you are talking against me, but let's extend it. Brother, if you don't want to see limitation here, dwell in the atmosphere of worship and praise. Lord, what I'm trusting you has not come yet, but I'm worshiping you. I'm thanking you for the admission that you are going to give me this year. I am worshiping you for the job you are about to give me this year. I am worshiping you for the healing you are giving me this year. And when you dwell in the atmosphere of worship and praise, there's no devil that is devil enough to limit you this year. It is called the atmosphere of worship and praise. Lord, I'm not giving a room. It is memory that leads to depression. Lord, I'm supposed to buy a car this year. You are not giving me a car. Lord, you have been showing me that I've been driving one car. Benz, to be precise. Camry Mozu, to be precise. Lord, I've not seen it. And then the next day, you cannot pray again because of car. Because the Camry Mozu has not come. So, you cannot pray again. You cannot pray again. Then all of a sudden, the depression enters. The Lord, you have been showing me Camry Mozu in the dream. I thank you for the Camry Mozu. I worship you for the, I don't know what I'm talking about. But somebody will buy a car this year. Somebody will buy a car this year. Lord, I thank you for this. I thank, and as you are thanking God, you will see that thanking will be actualized in the name of Jesus. Keys to breaking limitation. Number two, number three, is called the key of prayers. And they were praying, they were praising, and they were praying. And then all of a sudden, the siege was broken. Don't allow the devil to play with your altar this year. Don't allow the devil to, when the devil wants to strike a man, I've said it here before, and you will keep on hearing it as far as you are connected to this ministry, that when the devil wants to strike a man, the first thing the devil does is to fight your prayer altar. When you cannot pray again, you become a prey to the devil. When you cannot pray again, the devil can fool you with activities. You cannot pray. The devil can fool you with witness. You cannot pray. The devil can fool you with all manner of things, the worries of the world. You cannot pray. Never allow the devil, never allow anything to affect your fire. Lord, let nothing affect my prayer altar this year. I want you to set me on fire this year. I want to burn for you this year. Let my altar be charged this year. Let my altar be on fire this year. The problem is that people, when we are about to enter the year, people always go on retreats. There's nothing wrong with that. But it's not all about having retreat within the first 1 week. Then what happens to the remaining days? Maintain that same fire. You know, when we enter a new people, we are, this is a new calendar, let's go and see, it is good. There's nothing wrong with that. But there's a need to maintain that tenacity. What God wants is to maintain it. Lord, I did 3 days dry at the beginning of the year. There's grace. It has gone a long way. But to some extent, let that tenacity be maintained. Let it be maintained. That means if you are, don't say that 3 days dry will carry you all through 2022. You are dying. Don't say that, oh, you want to die. If you rest, then maintain a life of consistent prayer, consistent fasted life. Don't allow anything to affect your intimacy with God, you see. Because one thing that brings about intervention is prayers. When a man calls upon God, God answers in the place of prayers. And it is the intervention of God that arrests the limitation of life. It is the intervention, the answers from above, that arrest the spirit of limitation. Hallelujah. What are the keys to breaking limitation? Number 4. Is called the passion for his assignment. And Paul and Silas, they were in the move for God. They were passionate for his assignment. They never knew that something like an earthquake can happen, if not because they were in the assignment of God. They were doing the assignment passionately, and that was how people got angry and attacked them. But yet, the God that sent them for that assignment never left them. When you are in the move for God, you provoke the intervention of God. When you are passionate in the assignment of God, you provoke the intervention of God. Nobody that is genuinely in the move or in the move for God can be a victim to the devil. When a man is in the move for God, in the place of his assignment, where God wants him to be, what God wants him to do per time, that man cannot be a victim to the devil. So, beloved, challenging us tonight to be passionate for God this year. Passionate for God this year. Lord, I want to serve. Lord, I want to do your work. Jehovah, use me as you wish. Do with me as you wish, Lord. When you are passionate for the assignment of God, you will see the hand of intervention in the name of Jesus. To breaking limitation. Number 5 is called the key of the anointing. And thank God today is an anointing service. Everything that followed you from 2021 into 2022 will be arrested by the mantle in the name of Jesus. It is mantle that dismantle battles. It is mantle that arrests battles. It is mantle that handles battles. The anointing answers to the toiling of life. Oil is what answers to the toiling of life. And I believe that somebody tonight, the oil will speak for you tonight. In the name of Jesus. The oil will break anything that looks like a limitation, like a siege around you in the name of Jesus. This year you will achieve what nobody has achieved in your father. What nobody in your father's house has achieved. I don't know what I'm talking to, but the Lord just laid it in my spirit. What nobody has achieved in your father's house before. You are breaking that limitation. You are breaking that limitation. This year you are breaking that limitation. You believe that hell and fire.
You begin that highlight fire. You begin to shout the loudest, amen. And every seed upon this land, upon this community, every seed, every embargo of limitation upon this territory, this year that limitation is catching fire. You begin to shout the loudest, amen.
Keys to breaking limitation, number 6, and the final key. It's called the key of a life of uprightness. When a man is upright, that man finds himself upright right there. He finds himself upright there. When a man's life is a life that is full of uprightness, that man, you cannot be upright and then you are down in life. When a man is upright with God, that man is always a pace setter, is always on the high standard, on the high hill, on the high pedestal. Somebody, this year ask God, Lord, give me the grace to be upright. That means no double standardness. Lord, help me not to live a double standard life this year. Lord, help me not to live a life of ungodliness this year. Because sin is a reproach. When a man lives in sin, it reproaches him from getting to where God wants him to get to. Hallelujah. Hear me? You are in the service. You have a particular weakness. Make up your mind this year, Lord, I want to overcome this weakness. You were not born with that weakness. Since you were not born with it, it just came. That is how it will on its own. Lord, this weakness of a life that does not please you, this weakness of a life of immorality, I want to stop it this year. This weakness of doing things that later I will become angry with myself, Lord, I want to stop it this year. Hear me? Since they did not give birth to you with a bottle of beer, since they did not give birth to you with a stick of cigarettes or in their hand, it means that thing is a stranger. It means that thing is a visitor. It means that thing cannot dictate your life. That means if you make up your mind to drop that thing this year, that thing will leave you. You know what I'm talking about? So if there's anything that whenever you do it, all of a sudden your conscience, you are just pricked, you are angry with yourself. Make up your mind. I was not born, you were not born with pornography, you were not born with immorality. Make up your mind to stop it this year. And I believe that Jesus